Yo, what's up? DJ Truth here, and I am here to bring you a brand new tutorial, a beginner's tutorial on how you can become a DJ sitting right at home in front of your computer, no equipment needed. All you need is a computer and a little time, and I can show you how to do it. You ready? Let's go. So starting off, let's pretend you got a computer. If you don't have a computer, get a computer, get a laptop, get something, and let's do this. So today we're going to be using Serato DJ Pro. Now, I'm not going to take you through, matter of fact, yes, I will. I've already got it opened up, but go to Serato.com. Make sure you download Serato DJ. Download Serato DJ Pro. If you go to Serato.com, I'll show you. You'll get this great screen. They have other programs and things, but they have Serato Studio. They got Serato DJ Lite, but I want you to download Serato DJ Pro. Download Serato DJ Pro and install it. It's completely free if you download it, install it. And from there, I'm going to show you where we go. So I'm using a Mac. But if you're not using a Mac, it's the same thing. So I have it down here. Open it up. Open up your program. Once you get the program open, you're going to come to a screen. My screen may look a little different than yours, but I'm going to show you exactly what to do. So when it opens, my screen looks like this. If you're brand new to it, your screen won't look exactly like this. Your screen will actually look a little more like, I believe, like this. You might not have these songs down here. I'm not sure if it'll read your songs directly straight from iTunes, but I think it will. But if it doesn't, your screen will look like this, okay? So one thing, if you look up at the top, it's fairly simple, but I'm gonna break it down for you. So if you look up at the top, you have two circles. These are your decks. Basically, these are your turntables. You got a left deck and you got a right deck. You got play, I believe this is play from the beginning. You got sync button. Over here, you got your pitch slider. Over this side, you got your pitch slider. Basically, it's the same thing on both sides. This is your left side. This is your right side. Now, also up at the top, you have a couple of options. Some of these options you won't have straight out the gate, and I'm going to show you why. If I go to the top, you will have My Serato and Help. So I'm going to click My Serato. My Serato, I'm logged into My Serato. What I didn't show you in the beginning that I forgot to show you, when you go to Serato.com, you have to create a profile, create your name, you know, a password and everything. And that will give you access to My Serato. So make sure you create all of that on Serato.com. I don't even think you can download Serato DJ without creating those things first. So create those. Then when you come into your program that you download it, open up My Serato. Now, it has expansion packs and products. What I did is that I bought an expansion pack. Expansion pack, I believe, I don't remember the exact price. It's not expensive at all. I believe I might have paid, I don't know. I want to say like $15 or something like that. And it may be monthly. I don't even remember. But one of the expansions that I bought is Serato Play. Serato Play gives you options to basically DJ without having a DJ controller. There's been times when I've been at events and my DJ controller stopped working. One of the sides wasn't working. Just had all kinds of problems and I had to use Serato Play. Basically, you can DJ straight from your computer or laptop without anything else, you know. So I pay for Serato Play. Make sure you get Serato Play. All of these other things I can explain it to you later, but make sure you get Serato Play. This way you can have these functions that I'm about to show you. Do you absolutely need Serato Play if you're sitting at home? No, you don't. If you don't want to put the money into it, I get it. But what I'm going to show you is going to be with Serato Play. And your screen will still look like this, even if you don't get it. Some of these options you might not have. So one thing I'm going to change is the look. I'm used to the vertical look where you'll see where my waveforms go up, up and down instead of across, you know. So I'm going to show you. So if you look down here in Serato Play, you get you get an EQ for both sides too. So you got your low band, mid, high, and a filter. On this side, same thing. Filter, low, mid, high, same thing. Right here is your fader. This is your crossfader. So you can go from one side to another on your crossfader. So let's find a song. So over here on the left side, I have all selected. And basically, it's gonna find all the music that I have played in my Serato or that I have in my computer that I've put inside Serato. I don't think you'll have any music once you open this up because you haven't even done any of this yet. But what you should have is music from iTunes. If you don't have iTunes, download iTunes. Most of us use iTunes, so I'm going to pretend like we have iTunes. But if you don't have iTunes, download iTunes. It's just an easier way to organize your music and to keep it. But your iTunes folder will be available on here. So click your iTunes folder. And I'm not going to go through my crates or how to create a crate and different things like that, but I'm just going to show you the basics of click your iTunes folder and find a song that you want to play. So over here on the right side, this is my search bar. So what I'm going to do is click in my search bar and I'm going to type naughty by nature. So I didn't even have to type in the whole word. It started finding it for me. If you look, it has the song, you have the artist, you have the BPM, which is the speed, the key, and the date added. So I was already messing with this earlier. So if you notice, a few of my songs are blue. That means I've already played the song. I was messing with this earlier to get ready for this video. The songs in white, I haven't played any of those. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag two songs. I'm going to drag a song to the left side, and I'm going to drag a song to the right side. So I'm going to put Feel Me Flow over on the left. And I'm going to put Hip Hop Hooray over on the right deck. Now, one thing that I didn't mention earlier. Up top to the right, we have a help function. And we have, it says show shortcut keys. This right here will be your savior if you're just DJing straight from a computer. It will tell you exactly what key does what. There might be a few times in this video that I go look at this because I don't really DJ straight from my computer often, but I know it can be done and I have done it on several occasions. But me knowing these shortcut keys, no, I don't know them. I'm not going to lie. I literally have to look and tell you. I know a few, but for the most part, I don't know them. But this will be your savior. So make sure you use these shortcut playback keys. So I'm going to exit out of there. So as you can see, we have waveforms on the left, waveform on the right, and our crossfader is in the middle. Now, if you're not a DJ and you have no clue, this crossfader will allow you to play songs over on the left, or you can play a song on the right, or you can blend both songs in together. That is what the crossfader is for. Your EQ is simply to change the sound of the song. If you have too much bass and it sounds like this, you can take some of the low end out. If you have too much high and it sounds like that, you can take some of the high end out. Or, you know, this is just to adjust the sound, the frequency of how you hear it. Which when you really get into DJing, it's gonna become so important because every song is different. They're all at different frequencies. So you might have a song where a singer has a high pitched voice and you're playing it and all of a sudden you have to cut down the high. Or you might get a song where somebody it's kind of low and muffled, and a term we use is muddy, where it's not as clear. So you might have to brighten the sound and put high end in it. But these EQs are for you to use. So if you look over on this side, I know a lot of this may seem confusing, but I'll break down some of this stuff, some of the basic functions. So 90.4, this is the speed of the song. When you put a song into Serato, it'll detect the BPM. This is the speed. It'll detect it. It'll count the beats per measure, and then it'll come up with an estimate. Sometimes it's right. I mean, sometimes it's wrong. It's a little off, and then other times it's spot on, but for the most part, it's going to be pretty much spot on. If there's a song that where the tempo changes a lot, then sometimes it can't detect the BPM. And then you'll have to physically find the BPM yourself. But Feel Me Flow has a BPM, and it's actually the BPM of Feel Me Flow is, oh, it's 90. So if you look over here, I'm going to actually get rid of that cue point. You see these little plus symbols? These are cue points. Cue points are points in a song that you can add to start the song at that spot at any given time. So an example is what I do. My first cue point is always the first downbeat of a song. So if you take our, we can take our cursor, if you see that, and we can come up to this white line right here in the middle. This is basically our start line. This is like, it's a race and this is a start line. If I come over to the cue point on this left side and hit the plus symbol, I just added a cue point there. So now what I can do, I'll show you. It'll always start on that cue point. If I went somewhere else in the song, let's say there, and I add a second cue point, hit plus, now I can start it there, or I can go here to the beginning or to there. So cue points are adding adding places in the song where you want to start. For the most part, I know a lot of DJs, well, most of us, we all started on the first downbeat, and then we also sometimes we started on a chorus too. So if you just want the hook to replay over and over, you can put it on a cue point or just jump to it whenever you want to. So I got a cue point on this side. I'm actually going to delete the second one, and I'm going to put a cue point on this side. I actually have some over here, but let's just do it again. So this one, I'm going to put it there. I'll just show you. I hit the plus symbol. So now I can start it from there and keep it going. And this is me looping it. I'm actually changed the key so YouTube won't ban me. And I'll show you guys exactly what I just did. But if you notice, I changed the key and I'm looping it over and over. So you can loop it as much as you want. Or I can go to the other side. Wait, I'm gonna change the key. Now, if you notice, both songs are at two different BPMs. This says 90.4, this one says 99.0. So there's two ways. So as a DJ, your goal is to match these BPMs and get them at the same tempo so you can blend them in together. So what I would do is there's a button here, a sync button. If you hit sync, all of a sudden, 99, it matched to that one, 99. I'm going to take sync off. I'm going to take sync off over here. If I hit sync on this side, it's going to match it to the opposite side. So now both are 90. See? So let's do, matter of fact, I'm going to show you something else. We're going to go over to the left side and the right side. You see these sliders over here? This is also the BPM. So where you can change the pitch and speed the song up. So let's go. You can match it this way or you can hit the sync button. So let's go 93. It's 93.9. So there we are. Can also hit sync and now they're in sync. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start playing a song on the left side. So from the left side, I'm going to hit this cue point on my keyboard. Hitting that first cue point on this side, it's the number one on your keyboard. So if I hit number one, if I hold it down, it'll keep playing. If I release it, it'll stop. So if you hold down the number one, it'll play. But a shortcut that they have is the letter W for the left side. The letter W will start this to play without the cue point. So you can hit one or hit W to keep it playing. You can also stop the left side with W. The right side for this first cue point is the number six, or the letter S, so I can play without you holding the button. To stop it, just hit S again. So we're gonna work on, basically we're gonna have four buttons, that's it. We got one in W, six in S. And again, you can go up to the help, show shortcut keys, it'll show you all of that. It says set cue point or cue point jump, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So on this side, this is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On this side, it's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 to jump to those cue points. But today we're going to work with 1 for this side, 6 for this side, W for the left, S for the right. So, in a nutshell, we want to start both of these songs on time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit W to start the song. And I want to start the song on the right at the same time that one's playing. So I'm gonna just keep this one looping so it won't jump in. So my goal now, sorry, I cut it up a little too loud on my end. So my goal now is to start Hip Hop Hooray on beat with Filmy Flow. So I'm gonna go over to the right side, remember the number 6, and I'm gonna try to catch it. See, that was a little off. I was on. 3, 2, 3, 2, 1. And that's a little off, as you can see. So it's a little harder with just with buttons to catch it, but we'll try it again. There it is. Now you have this crossfader here that you can start mixing. So watch this. And what I'm doing is I'm fading over to the next song. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna find another song. Let's go to OPP. So, now if you notice, you can only, I'm gonna bring this down just a little bit. Now you only hear the right side. You can't hear the left side because we took the fader and we went over to the right side. So I'm gonna go over to this song on the left. Matter of fact, let's just do Beyonce, Naughty Girl. All right, so I'm changing the pitch right here. If you notice, I'm coming up. I'm changing the pitch. This is only for YouTube because I don't want YouTube to flag me for playing these people's songs. Beyonce's original BPM is 100. This is the original BPM up top. Hip Hop Parade is 99. Right now, we're both at 93. So both of them are a little slower. So what I'm going to do is grab this pitch fader and start speeding it up. And if you notice, because we're in sync, I'm pulling up the speed on both sides. So, what I'm gonna do now is this Beyonce song. Remember, this first cue point. Now, I already had this set, but if we didn't have it set, we'll take the Beyonce song, you can drag it to the beginning if you want. We're gonna put a cue point there. Remember, you can hit the plus symbol. So now I have a cue point here. So now my goal is to start this cue point on time with this, but I can't hear it because I have this crossfader all the way on that side. So I'm gonna come a little over so I can hear it. So we wait for the downbeat. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Now, I don't know if you guys can hear that. And now I'm fading over to the left side. And we'll do one more. So I faded over to the left side. Now remember what I told you about the EQs? I'm gonna show you this EQ. You got high, mid, low. You could add bass. Let's see. Or take bass out. Or you can add high or take high out and make it muffled. Now you ask, why would you do that? Why would you need to do that? And I'm going to show you again. Every song is different. I just added Uptown Anthem to the right side. Now again, I'm going to change the pitch. Up here is your key. You can change it up here. I'm going to hit 6 because I already had this cue point set. So now I'm going to hit 6 just to start it on time. Now, this BPM is 103. Beyonce is 100. Original BPM. Right now, we're both at 102. So let's go up a little. So now I'm going to start mixing the other song, this Uptown Anthem with Naughty Girl. Now here, I'm going to pull out the low end. I pulled out the bass out of Naughty Girl so it wouldn't clash with the bass in Uptown Anthem. And then we'll start sliding it over. Hey, you can smoke a split with a clip, but they're still on Mountain Pie, you know. Oh, wide enough to And right there is the basics on mixing your songs. You can go back and forth. Now, I didn't show you guys this, but you can also record this. So when you hit this record tab up here at the top, it pops up right here. And this is how you can make your own pre-made DJ mixes. Now, this record tab will not be there if you did not go to, remember, go to My Serato, and it's going to make you log in. It has my information already logged in. And expansion packs, I'm sorry, my products. It's showing you the products that I have from Serato. You got to get Serato Play, or that record function won't be up there, and you can't just record a DJ mix. So I could record this and save it. So right now, if you notice, this is the volume. You hit record, and then it's just recording. When it's all done, you name it. I'm gonna just say practice Serato. Once you hit save, now you have this. So I'm gonna show you exactly what just happened. And I'm gonna hit the play button to stop it. Now, if you look, practice Serato, it went down into this crate that I have down here called Recorded. This crate is automatically created in Serato. You come down to record it. You grab the song, whatever you just recorded, put it there, and guess what? It is now right here. So my entire DJ mix, even though I was only recording for a few seconds, it's now here. So you can have an entire DJ mix recorded while you're doing this. And then you can pull it up and play it back whenever you want to. Again, these are just some basic functions. I didn't dive deep into it. I can dive deep into it with another tutorial, but this is the basics. I just want you guys, like, who's brand new to this, who's never even DJed, who never opened up a program. I want you to really understand what's going on here and showing you the basics. I didn't break down any of this. This is like as far as with your loops and anything like that. You don't have to. I don't have to show you that right now. Just work on going back and forth between songs, making your DJ playlist from your computer. If you have a controller, these functions are a lot easier to maneuver through. But if you don't have a controller, you are all good, because I do it. I've done it before. I'm not going to say I do it all the time, but I've done it before. And if I needed to, if I was in a club with 1,000 people or more and didn't have a controller and you said I had to rock the party just like this, I could still do it. And I'm absolutely sure you could too. So this is basically the basic functions of Serato DJ. If you got any questions, hit me up. DJ Truth, I'm here. I'm making a bunch of tutorials, so I'm going to show you guys everything I know. All right, peace.